Hi there, wonderful people. Before we dive in, do us a favor and hit that like button and subscribe for more exciting content. Today, we're flipping the script and starting from the end. We'll be discussing the 10 educational differences between the rich and poor, but in reverse order. That's right. We're starting at number 10 and working our way to the most significant difference at number 1. Education is the key to success, but not all keys are made equal. We'll explore these differences from learning environments to parental involvement, from access to technology to educational expectations. We'll look at how these aspects can shape an individual's educational journey and potentially their future. So if you've ever wondered how different the educational journeys of the rich and poor can be, you're in the right place. Now buckle up as we start from difference number 10. Kicking off at number 10, we have the learning environment. Picture this. A state-of-the-art classroom with all the latest tech, surrounded by vast green spaces for outdoor learning. This is the reality for many well-off students. They get to learn in an environment that's not just comfortable, but also conducive to their growth and development. On the flip side, students from less privileged backgrounds may not be as lucky. Their classrooms might be overcrowded, under-resourced, and in some cases, even lacking basic amenities. This disparity can create challenges that go beyond just academic performance. It can affect a student's motivation, engagement, and overall well-being. Of course, this isn't always the case. There are many exceptional students who thrive despite their circumstances. But on a broader scale, the quality of the learning environment can significantly impact a student's educational journey. That wraps up difference number 10. Let's move to number 9. At number 9, we've got tutoring. It's a remarkable tool, isn't it? A chance to dive deeper, to understand better, to master the subject matter. Now, imagine having a private tutor at your disposal. A luxury, right? Well, for many affluent kids, this luxury is a reality. With a private tutor, they can focus on their weaknesses and enhance their strengths, getting that extra edge they need. On the flip side, let's take a walk in the shoes of those less fortunate. For them, a private tutor is often a distant dream. They may have to rely on self-study or group study with friends. But hey, don't underestimate the power of determination and hard work. Many of these kids are putting in the effort, and their grit is truly commendable. So whether it's a private tutor or a group study session in the park, the goal is the same: to learn, to grow, and to succeed. That's it for number 9. Next is number 8. Number 8 on our list is nutrition. What we eat is not just about keeping our stomachs full, it's about fueling our brains for the day. A well-balanced diet can enhance cognitive function, improve concentration, and even boost academic performance. Now, wealth can play a significant role in shaping a child's diet. Families with more financial resources often have better access to fresh, nutrient-rich foods, which can positively impact a child's learning abilities. On the other hand, less affluent families may struggle to afford these nutritious options, and as a result, their children might end up consuming more processed foods that lack essential nutrients. This disparity in nutrition can create a gap in educational outcomes. After all, it's challenging to focus on algebra or Shakespeare when your stomach is growling, right? So, nutrition is not just about physical health, but also about academic health. That's why it's number 8 on our list. Now, let's see what's at number 7. Coming in at number 7 is parental involvement. Now, this is a big one. You see, in affluent families, parents often have more flexibility and resources to be involved in their child's education. They can afford to take time off work to attend school functions, help with homework, or even hire tutors for additional support. On the other hand, parents from less privileged backgrounds may be working multiple jobs, leaving them with little time or energy to invest in their child's academic journey. It's not that they don't want to, but the circumstances make it challenging. Moreover, wealthier parents tend to have higher educational attainment themselves, which not only sets a higher academic expectation for their children, but also equips them with the knowledge to guide their kids through complex schoolwork. Remember, parental involvement is crucial in a child's education, regardless of economic status. It's not always about money. It's about commitment, encouragement, and support. That was number 7. Next up, number 6. Number 6 is all about technology. We're in the 21st century, folks. Technology isn't just about playing the latest version of Angry Birds or snapping the perfect selfie for Instagram. It's a powerful tool for learning, a gateway that opens up a world of information and interactive educational resources. But here's the catch. Not everyone has the same level of access to this digital treasure trove. financial status plays a significant role in dictating a child's access to educational technology. Affluent families can often afford to provide their children with the latest laptops, tablets, and software, creating a rich, interactive learning environment at home. In contrast, children from less wealthy families may have limited, if any, access to such resources. This disparity in access to technology can lead to a significant gap in educational opportunities and outcomes. It's a tough nut to crack, but awareness is the first step toward change. That was number 6. Let's move on to number 5. We're halfway through. Number 5 is educational trips. Now let's imagine a child's world expanding beyond the four walls of a classroom. That's the magic of educational trips. They have the power to turn the world into a live textbook, with lessons that stick for a lifetime. However, not all kids have the same opportunities when it comes to these trips. For children from wealthier families, these trips are often seen as a regular part of their education. They may visit museums, historical sites, scientific labs, and even foreign countries. These experiences provide them with a broader view of the world, sparking curiosity and fostering a deeper understanding of what they're learning in school. On the flip side, children from less affluent backgrounds might not have these experiences due to financial constraints. These missed opportunities can limit their exposure to the world beyond their immediate environment. That's number 5 done. Let's see what's at number 4. Next on our list at number 4 is extracurricular activities. Now, don't you just love the thrill of a football match under the floodlights or the satisfaction of nailing that difficult violin piece? Extracurricular activities are an integral part of a holistic education. They provide an opportunity to develop skills outside the classroom, build self-confidence, and foster teamwork. But here's the catch. They often come with a price tag. For families with a larger budget, these activities are a given. Horse riding lessons, international summer camps, robotics workshops, they're all on the table. These experiences not only enrich the child's learning, but also offer networking opportunities. However, for families with lesser means, these activities may be considered luxuries. The costs of equipment, uniforms, travel, or even the activity fees themselves can be prohibitive. As a result, children from less affluent backgrounds may miss out on these enriching experiences. That was number 4. Let's see what's at number 3. Coming in at number 3 is school quality. Now, here's an interesting fact. Not all schools are created equal. Affluence can greatly impact the type of school a child attends. Wealthy families often have the means to send their children to private schools with smaller class sizes, better facilities, and highly qualified teachers. These schools generally have more resources, including advanced courses and extracurricular activities that can enhance a child's educational experience. On the flip side, children from less affluent families often attend public schools that may lack adequate funding. This can result in larger class sizes, fewer resources, and less individual attention for students. The disparity in school quality can significantly affect a child's educational trajectory and future opportunities. It's important to remember that while wealth can influence school quality, it doesn't determine a child's ability to learn or their potential for success. It's the resilience, determination, and passion for learning that truly make a difference. That's number 3. Let's see what's at number 2. Almost there. Number 2 is early education. Early education is like the foundation of a building. It's the first step in a child's learning process and plays a critical role in shaping their cognitive and social development. Now, here's where the wealth factor comes in. Children from wealthier families often have access to high-quality preschool programs, while those from less affluent families might not. These programs provide an enriching environment filled with stimulating activities that foster creativity, cognitive development, and social skills. Moreover, wealthy parents often have the resources to provide additional educational materials and experiences outside of school, enhancing their child's early learning. On the flip side, less affluent families may struggle to provide these opportunities due to financial constraints. This disparity in early education can create a learning gap that persists throughout a child's academic journey. To put it in perspective, it's like starting a race a few steps behind. That was number 2. Now for our top difference. And finally, at number 1, we have educational expectations. It's no secret that wealth can greatly influence the expectations set for a child's education. More affluent families often have high academic expectations for their children, pushing them towards advanced classes and college degrees. This isn't to say that less affluent families don't have expectations, but the focus may be more on practical skills and immediate employment after high school. Why is this so? Well, it's mostly because wealthier families have the resources to provide for a longer educational journey. They can afford the high tuition fees of universities and support their child throughout their studies. On the other hand, families with fewer resources might prioritize financial stability and immediate income over higher education. In the end, it's important to remember that every family's situation is unique. The key here is to recognize the potential impact of economic status on educational expectations. That's our top difference, folks. Let's wrap things up. And that's a wrap on our countdown of 10 educational differences between the rich and the poor. We began our journey with a look into learning environments and how they can greatly differ based on socioeconomic status. We then stepped into the world of tutoring, nutritional impacts on education, and the crucial role of parental involvement. Remember when we explored the vast divide in access to technology, the opportunities provided by educational trips, and the importance of extracurricular activities? We also shed light on the varying degrees of school quality and the profound effect of early education. And last but not least, we touched on the subject of educational expectations and how they can shape a child's future. These 10 differences are important to recognize and understand as we strive for educational equity. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more informative and engaging content. See you next time.